So let's talk about collagen synthesis. It occurs inside as well as outside the cell. Now, which cells? Mainly fibroblasts. That is the main connective tissue in the body. And along with it, there are other cells such as osteoblasts in bones and chondroblasts in cartilage. What a connecting family. For collagen synthesis, cell requires nucleus, rough endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, and extracellular enzymes. It all starts from here. Nucleus have DNA, and DNA have thousands of genes. In these 1000 genes, 22 genes are for collagen production. And these 22 genes make 10 different collagen precursors proteins. So, collagen gene in nucleus undergoes transcription and it produces messenger RNA. This baby RNA comes out of nucleus and here it is taken up by its partner, ribosomes. These ribosomes are attached on rough endoplasmic reticulum and here it undergoes translation and it produces a polypeptide which is known as pre-pro-alpha chain. And it undergoes different modifications while it is still being produced. And why these modifications are necessary? Well, I will explain that soon. Now, this pre-pro-alpha chain enters into the lumen of rough endoplasmic reticulum. And here, its N-terminal accessory amino acids got removed. These accessory amino acids actually work as a signaling molecule and it helps in entry of this pre-pro-alpha chain into the lumen of rough endoplasmic reticulum. That is why it is also known as signal sequence peptide. After its removal, the remaining molecule is known as pro-alpha chain and it undergoes some modifications. Number 1. Hydroxylation. Collagen have specific sequence of amino acids such as glycine, X and Y. Here, X may be prolein or lysine and Y also have initially prolein and lysine that undergoes hydroxylation. Now, it became hydroxyproline and hydroxylysine. And this reaction occurs in the presence of prolyl hydroxylase and lysyl hydroxylase. The function of these enzymes is evident from its name, isn't it? And this hydroxylation helps in combining the fibrils of collagens. And how it works? Just wait a little bit. I will explain that. And most important, this reaction occurs in the presence of iron and vitamin C. Modification number 2. Glycosylation. Cell have glucose and galactose. These glucose and sometimes galactose come together and get attached to hydroxylysine. Not all, just some of these. Now what's the importance of this? So our textbook don't explain that. But our resources have found that it could have different functions such as assembly of collagen fibrils, collagen cross-linkage, and collagen interaction with different other biomolecules. But all of these are just proposed theories. Now let's move to the next step. Assembly and secretion. After hydroxylation and glycosylation, three pro-alpha chains come closer and make interactions within the same chain and with neighboring chain. Now, what we can call this interaction? Disulfide bridges. Now, a new molecule is formed which we can call procollagen and it have propeptides on N and C terminal. Now, what is the importance of this? So, it is also not mentioned in our textbook, Lipin code. But after some research, we found that it prevents premature degradation of procollagen. This procollagen now go to Golgi apparatus and is ready for leaving the cell. So here ends our intracellular collagen synthesis. And let's start extracellular collagen synthesis. After secretion, propeptides are removed. And it is done by N-procollagen peptidase and C-procollagen peptidase. Now, the procollagen is called tropocollagen. Here, collagen faces two fates. Either it can become long fibrils, for example, collagen type 1, 2, and 3, or it can make mesh network, just like collagen 9 and 11. So we concern about fibrils, not mesh network. Tropocollagen spontaneously combines and make an ordered overlapping parallel array with staggered pattern, adjacent to neighbor by 3/4 molecule length. And now it's called collagen fibril. Did you understand? Now, let me explain. This is one tropocollagen and this is another one. They combine in such a way that they leaves a gap of 3/4 of a molecule of collagen itself from its nearby molecule. And it happens to all of molecules. And we get equally distance placed arrangement, which is known as staggered pattern. Under electron microscope, a part of it seems black and the other seems white. Did you get that? Now, the final step. Collagen fibrils require some power, and this is done by cross-linkage formation. So here is the story. A minor group on lysine and hydroxylation is got removed in the presence of lysyl hydroxylase. And the remaining group, which is aldehyde group, come closer and combines with a minor group of another chain, and this results in a condensation reaction and a cross linkage is formed. Remember, this lysyl oxidase is a copper containing enzyme, unlike the lysyl hydroxylase. So here ends our collagen synthesis. See you again in next video.